with very well.
I did.
Yeah. Do you want to talk a little bit about her? And also John Bowlby, of course.
But I knew Mary much better. I knew Bowlby. But see, he was Bowlby. He wasn't John to me. Mary was Mary. Mm-hmm. And I worked with her for a little bit more than 10 years. So...
Can you say something about her legacy or her contribution or her, you know, what she's responsible for in terms of your work?
Well, I mean, she gave us the ABCs, but in my work, what comes to mind right now is she taught me always to look at the hypothesis that didn't work. Okay, do the study, get your P level, fine, now you can publish. But you didn't get 100% of whatever it was. Look at all the cells, the individuals, the whatever, that didn't fit your hypothesis, because everything you're going to learn is in those people who you thought would be some way, but they are a different way. Her comfort with the part of the hypothesis that didn't work, and with believing that all the excitement is there and the discrepancy, that has served me very well. Every study that I've done, I've known the hypothesis was going to work. I've seen it or piloted. I know it's going to work. All the excitement is where it didn't work, because those are the people who have something to teach me. That and the incredibly careful observation that she did. We spent hours and hours looking at videotapes in little dark rooms, and she's writing in this minuscule, perfect handwriting everything that she sees. My ability to see detail comes in part from all these hours of observing with her and knowing that there are little fragments that you don't see the first time through. But once you've found them, you can find them two times, three times, five times, and make meaning out of them. Mm-hmm. The detail, the functional meaning rather than the behavior. We never counted behaviors. We never made lists of behaviors. We never checked them off. We're always looking for functional patterning. Mm-hmm. And she taught me to do that. So
looking for what the function of the behavior was, what the behavior was aimed to do, trying to achieve.
And being able to substitute then another behavior. So the child smiled to engage the mother, but then came back and offered the toy to engage the mother. And you can find a pattern that every time the mother's face falls, the child does something to perk her up. A smile, a toy offer, a touch. And suddenly you see that each of those fulfilled the same function. So you're not counting smiles. You're counting functions of mother looks distant, child does something that brings her back. And now you can get a caregiving strategy out of that. You can't get it if you only count smiles.